Hello, my name is Nupur Jha. As part of my IEP assignment, I'm going to talk about the impact of COVID-19 on the financial sectors of the country. COVID-19 has brought unprecedented disruption to the health and economy of India. The 21-day lockdown has brought many businesses to a standstill. But one of the weakest links of the Indian economy is the banking sector. Let us try to understand the reasons behind this. First of all, the banks had still not recovered from the bad loans that they had issued in the boom years. To control the NPAs, they had already been conservative to lend to new projects, and this was reflected in their high interest rates, despite RBI slashing repo rates consecutively 5 times last year. Looking at the current lockdown scenario, as per Moody's, a sharp decline in the economic activity and a rise in the unemployment will lead to a deterioration of the household and corporate finances, which in turn will lead to an increase in delinquencies. Secondly, the consumption has gone down significantly amid the COVID-19 crisis. Demand for houses, vehicles, white goods, generally which are brought through credit from banks, has vanished. The same is expected to continue even few months after the lifting of the lockdown. Finally, the default of Yes Bank had created an atmosphere of speculation in the banking system. Coupled with declining in an economy, it will lead to risk aversion among depositor and creditors, creating funding and liquidity challenges for smaller private sector players. As per Moody's, the credit supply to the economy will be hampered by volatility in global financial markets, and this will lead to higher risk aversion between participants. The public sector banks and large private banks will not be impacted that much, as funding and liquidity will be relatively stable given their well-established franchises with strong depositor bases. But as for the non-bank financiers and the smaller players, the stress will limit their capacity to lend, further hindering India's economic growth. A report by S&P Global Ratings says that the NPA ratio in India is likely to be 1.9%, but the credit costs ratios will be worse, increasing by about 130 basis points. The Reserve Bank of India, as part of its post-coronavirus intervention, permitted banks to grant a moratorium of 3 months on loan installments. But it is not clear how helpful this measure is going to be. We can conclude by saying the recovery is going to be long and rough. But in uncertain times like this, we must remember that we can revive the economy later, but we cannot bring back the dead. Thank you so much.